this video, I'm going to help you understand a very important concept, that is momentum is equal to Newton's second law.
Dropping the rock on the glass, its initial momentum is zero and final momentum is 31.5 kilogram meter per second.
You saw in the experiment that momentum is equal to Newton's second law. So now your experimental understanding is going to be supplemented by your theoretical understanding, both important. Okay, so now theoretical understanding. Newton's second law is equal to momentum. All right, Newton's second law is F equal to ma, of course. And what is momentum? Momentum is equal to, of course, P equal to mb. All right, so we are saying that this equal to this. All right, and you saw it in the experiment. Now you're going to see the theoretical. So Newton wrote, when 1665, Newton conceptualized this idea that there was an apple over here and there was a moon a little bit above the apple, and he saw apple fall, and he started asking a question: if apple fall, why doesn't moon fall? And he later realized that apple fall, and just like apple, moon also fall. So now the second question was, apple fall and he saw apple touching the ground. Why then he also realized that moon fall? Why the moon doesn't touch the ground? Because apple initial velocity was zero. Moon velocity is not zero. Velocity is that what keeps moon not falling, not hitting the earth. Okay? So Newton wrote in his Principia Mathematica, which he was conceptualized this idea 1665, and he published it 1687. And he wrote it like this: delta P over delta T. This is how he wrote his second law. Now let's see how much we go from here. Now delta P is equal to, so P is equal to mb. So what is delta P? Delta P is equal to m delta V. So let's see how far we can go with this. So we're going to replace this one by m delta V over delta T. Now from the flipped classroom video, you saw one thing: acceleration is Vf minus Vi over Tf minus Ti. So this can be rewritten as Vf over T, delta V over delta T. So let's replace this by M and this one A. So then this can be written as delta P over delta T. All right, so what does that mean? That means Newton's second law is equal to momentum. All right, this is the proof. You're gonna use the data from the experiment to get the constant. To get the constant, gravitational constant, and find the value.
Subscribe to Bari Science Lab to fall in love with math and science, especially programming.